Thank you all so much for coming out this afternoon. It means a lot, especially knowing what's all going on at Gamage and how I'm sure that makes things more difficult. That first piece was by Barbara York entitled Prophecies. Barbara York was a Canadian composer who spent a lot of her life in the United States in the state of Kansas. Initially, when I was planning out this recital, it was going to be her concerto that a lot of you probably heard more times than you'd like. And by the time that the concerto competition was done, Dr. Swoboda and I decided, let's hang it up and do something new. So for Gail and I, that's been about 3 weeks of work. So thanks to Gail for turning that around in that kind of time. Everything you are going to hear tonight is an original work by a woman composer written for a low brass instrument, the one I'm going to play it on, in the last 10 years. 11 because 2012. Kind of ties into my doctoral project that's going to be a database of solo and chamber works original for tuba and euphonium since 2012, and I figured let's put it into practice. I have spent a lot of time kind of working on my doubling over the course of this degree, and this next piece, Lauren Bernofsky's Two Latin Dances, just the first movement, is going to be my solo premiere on tenor trombone. So if you're not a fan of it, it's only like 3 minutes long, so it'll be done soon.
Thank you.
like a quick first half, but the next piece is a little bit more sizable. This is Elena Specht's Rip Van Winkle Concertino for Tuba. Elena Specht is a young American composer who lives in Michigan. She recently finished her doctorate at Michigan State. This is a programmatic work telling the story of Rip Van Winkle. If you're unfamiliar, I'll give you a quick rundown. Early 19th century American folktale about a Dutch settler in colonial America named Rip Van Winkle. He was kind of a layabout. He didn't really like to work, but he was a good person at heart. And one day, to get away from his wife, he went into the mountains, as I guess one did in those days. In the mountains, he found a mysterious Dutchman who had a barrel of liquor on his back, and the Dutchman said, "Want some?" He said, "Yes. Please don't do that. That's a bad idea." He woke up about 20 years later, post-American Revolution, and it's like, imagine if that happened to you. So you go through kind of his life being a little bit lazy, wandering into the mountains, drinking some mysterious liquor, and waking up in a totally new country. So enjoy Elena Specht's Rip Van Winkle. Thank you. work to open up the second half is Carolina Calvache's Encuentros. Relatable. Carolina Calvache is a Colombian composer. Most of her music is in more of a popular idiom, but she does have several works for trombone, bass trombone, as well as tuba. Encuentros, as you can maybe guess by the picture, means encounters, and the idea is encounters with solitude. So the emotions and the feelings and the thoughts that run through your head when you're kind of all by yourself. Especially in music, a lot of us can be very new to ourselves in our head. And I think you get moments of that, and then ending with the more calm, you know, everything's going to be okay. So please enjoy Carolina Calvache's Encuentros.
Thank you.
out kind of what to say to all of you to describe these pieces, because as questionable as some moments may be, I do try and plan what I'm going to say in advance. I realize that a lot of these pieces are very programmatic. A lot of them have stories and kind of backgrounds, and it's important to understand that. The next piece, Kepler 836b by Nicole Chamberlain. Nicole Chamberlain is an American composer based in Georgia who plays the flute, and most of her compositions are for the flute. But she does have two works for tuba at the moment. This one, another one really suited to contrabass tuba, talking about Hannibal's elephants crossing the Alps. And she's currently writing a sonata for Chris Dickey as well. When I was trying to pick between the two, because it's like, okay, one with electronics, I did a whole recital with electronics, and another with piano, I vetted it past non-tuba players, so because I wanted their opinions too. And they really like this one because it sounds like something that, you know, you wouldn't normally hear on the tuba. This was commissioned by William Pritchard with his purchase of an Eastman 836 tuba, right? And what way to celebrate getting a new tuba, like commissioning a piece. And in her research, Nicole found the relationship of, oh, hey, the Kepler spacecraft found this planet, 836b. That works. And so this is a piece that kind of goes through the story of the Kepler spacecraft. It's still going, it's still finding things, but ultimately, I mean, what happens is they launch it, and it goes into space until it runs out of gas, right? So you get all of the adventures of what it finds in space, and then the eventual, as things start to shut down and slow down. Thank you. Two recitals, I've made a point to contact the composers. I've had the fortune that in the last two recitals, I've only had one composer who isn't still alive, still with us. And so I send them the program, I tell them that I'm playing their music, and I would think from a composer standpoint, hey, that's really important because they need the program if they want to get paid by ASCAP and shown that people are playing their music. As a composer, I mean, having knowing that people are playing what you're already writing, especially things that you think, you know, oh, this doesn't do as well. I don't write a lot of tuba music, so it probably won't get played a lot. Let them know that you're playing their stuff. It means a lot to them. I learned from my contact with Nicole that as far as she's aware, that's the second time that piece has been played besides the premiere. So I mean, that's really cool for me. Hopefully it is to you, and I know that it means a lot to her as well. So contact your composers. The penultimate piece is Desert Rose by Mino Kabasawa. Mino Kabasawa is a Japanese composer who primarily does film and TV music, and so it sounds a lot like that. I chose to interpret the Desert Rose, I mean, what better place to play it than in the desert, as the blooms of a cactus. You have a lot of similarities with a rose. Right? It's this beautiful flower, and you want to be really careful and not grab onto things. And I think the piece really highlights that. Beautiful soaring melodies that, at least from my point of view, are kind of treacherous because they just go and they're high. So enjoy Mino Kabasawa's Desert Rose.
Thank you.
here. I have a pedestal, I have thank yous, and then I have the piece. So I'm really passionate about trying to program works where it doesn't necessarily have to feel like an hour-long recital to you. I think we as performers need to be aware of what it's like to be an audience member and do our best to showcase a variety of things that have some kind of tying together theme, but that is still fun to listen to, and hopefully it's as fun for you to hear as it is for me to play. The thank yous. My wonderful wife, Rachel, my rock, right? I couldn't ask for a better partner, a better person to spend the rest of my life with. You're a wonderful mother, and you're so helpful when I need grounding. My parents for being like the longest supporters, my biggest fans, right? If anyone's going to have a banner, it's going to be them. And I mean, like, getting 3 degrees in music, you got to really love your kid to let them do that. To the incomparable Gail Novak. Right? Yeah! It's wonderful to have a pianist that is a wonderful collaborator. Makes my job a lot easier and covers up my mistakes. And of course, Dr. Swoboda, of like the things that I imagine a professor having of like, this is the dream. She has everything, right? Like so supportive of everything that I want to do, and has the step-by-step of here's what you can do to get there. And wow, I love this university, I love this studio. And I thank you all, to all of you for coming. The last piece is Cait Nishimura's Golden Hour. Now, I lied at the beginning. I said all of the pieces on this recital were originally for the instruments I'm playing them on. This one is not, sorry. It was originally written for horn in 2020, and Jarrett McCourt, Canadian tuba player who teaches at Vanderbilt, was like, this is really good. Can you make it for tuba? And she did, and it's really good. I figured recitals are like an hour, golden hour, it's 5 p.m., and it's a recital of new music by women composers, so I figured it all kind of tied in. There aren't a lot of pieces that the first time I hear it, I go, I love that, I want to play that, and this is one of those pieces. Hopefully you have a similar experience.
Thank you. Thank you.